Hello friends, my name is B.K. Kollapure. Today we will take up the topic on bending stresses. We see that whenever we take a beam, if I simply support the beam at the ends and if I subject it to loading, this beam is going to bend. This type of bending, it is known as sagging bending moment. Sagging, it is bending in the sagging form. So when you see this, the bottom fibers are subjected to tension and the top fibers are subjected to compression. Suppose if I take a small portion and if I magnify that part here in the bent form, you get that this is the lower part, this is the upper part, and this is the layer in between. This is the center of the curvature. If it bends like this, this is the center of the curvature. So you see here the bottom fibers, they are subjected to tension because they are stretching, and the top fibers are subjected to compression because they are getting compressed. Simple example we can show. If I cut this figure, so you find a figure something like this. It is going to bend in this direction. It is a center where it is meeting. You see here the bottom parts are stretching and the upper parts are getting compressed. So if you see it like this, in this form, the bottom fiber are in tension, the top fiber are in compression. If you see it to the bent form, tension is maximum here, stretching is maximum here, and as we move towards the center, the stretching goes on decreasing. Similarly, the compression is maximum here on the top. If I move towards the middle, the compression is going on decreasing. There is one layer here, neither there is tension nor there is compression. We call this layer as the neutral layer. The fibers above neutral layer are in compression. The fibers below the neutral layer are in tension. Suppose if I cut this cross section, if I cut the cross section, you see that whenever I cut the cross section, the neutral layer being is cut here. So this is known as the neutral axis, where there is neither tensile forces or tensile stresses, or there are compressive stresses. If you draw the bending stress diagram for this, you get that if I draw a cross section, this is a neutral layer, we call it as neutral axis. These parts are in compression, so compressive stress. These parts are in tension, we call it as tensile stress. This diagram what we are drawing, we know as bending stress diagram. So our aim in this topic is to find, draw the bending stress diagram for the beam. Here we come across a very important theory based upon this principle, what we call as bending equation. We also call it as pure bending, and we also call the formula as Bernoulli's equation. Bernoulli's equation, this is given as M by I is equal to F by Y is equal to E by R. M by I is equal to F by Y is equal to E by R, where M is the bending moment, I is moment of inertia, F is the bending stress, Y is the distance of extreme fiber. We have seen, if this is a rectangular cross section, this is B and this is D. If this is a neutral axis, which is at the center, so here this is the distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis. This is in compression, so YC. This is the distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis. This will be YT, because tension is at the bottom, compression is at the top. Y is the distance of extreme fiber from neutral axis. E we know is the Young's modulus, and R is the radius of curvature. What we have seen here, this is the radius of curvature where the beam is going to bend. So if you know these three four relations, you can find out any wanted thing, knowing the data what is given to you. So m by I is equal to f by y is equal to e by r. You have this formula. We are using this formula even in the designing of the structures. So this is a very basic formula what you are doing. So derivation is in the notes, you can see through that. So today we will see how to use these equation to draw the bending stress diagrams. M by I is equal to F by Y is equal to E by R. Now, if we use the relation M by I is equal to F by Y, M if I write is equal to I by Y into F. This I call it as ZF, where Z is known as the section modulus. And this section modulus is nothing but I by Y. I is the moment of inertia and Y is the distance of the extreme fiber from the neutral axis. So here we will try to find out the section modulus of some of the regular figures what we are using. The very common figure what we will be using in beams is a rectangle. Z for rectangle. That is section modulus for rectangle. Suppose if I take a beam, if the cross section of the beam is V by D. So here V no section modulus is given by I by Y. This is the neutral axis of the beam which is at the center. This neutral axis will be at the centroid. Centroid of rectangle is at the center. So this, if I write it, moment of inertia of a rectangle is given by B d cube divided by 12. And the distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis, either this distance or this distance, both are same here. So this is d by 2. So you get Z is equal to B d squared by 6. We know the relation M is equal to FZ. So for rectangular section, M is given by BD squared by 6 into F. You can remember this formula. BD squared by 6 into F. This is a section modulus for a rectangular section. Likewise, you can see the section modulus for other sections also. So we have seen here for the rectangle. If you see to the circular section, we take a circular section, this is a neutral axis at the center, this is the diameter of the circle. We know section modulus is given by I by Y. This is equal to, what is the moment of inertia of a circle? Pi d 4th by 64. Pi d 4 by 64 is the moment of inertia divided by, what is the distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis? That is nothing but the radius, and radius is nothing but d by 2. So section modulus for a circular section is given by pi d cube by 32. Pi d cube by 32. If you take a rectangle, hollow rectangle, then if this is a hollow rectangle, B by D, outer dimension. If I have got a hollow here, then the inter dimension, if they are B and D, then section modulus is given by I by Y. It's a hollow section. Moment of inertia of rectangle is BD cube by 12. So this will be BD cube by 12 outer minus BD cube by 12 inner. This is equal to distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis. This will be the distance of extreme fiber. Or this will be the distance of extreme fiber from the neutral axis. This is capital D divided by 2. So this will be equal to d by 2. So if you simplify this, 1 by 12 and 1 by 2 they are common, so 1 by 6 is left out. B d cube minus b d cube divided by d. So this is how you can go on finding out for any type of section to find out the section modulus. It is nothing but I by y. Going further, we'll try to implement or use the Bernoulli's equation or pure bending formula, m by I is equal to f by y is equal to a by r. We'll try to solve the problems on that. Suppose if there is a beam, if it is simply supported at both ends, and if it is carrying a UDL, let the span of the beam be 6 meters and the load carried by the beam be 10 kilonewton per meter. If the cross section of the beam is given to you, if the cross section is 200 by 400, so BD is known to you, then you are required to find out what is the bending stress acting in this beam. So here load is given to you, span is known to you. We are going to use the relation M by I is equal to F by Y. This will give us the bending stress. Or we already seen for rectangular section, bending moment M is equal to Fz, and we have found this is 1 by 6 B D squared into F. Now here M can be determined, which is a bending moment acting, load is known, span is known. You can find that bending moment is equal to W L squared by 8, simply supported beam. So this will be equal to 10 into 6 square divided by 8. So you get the value of bending moment here as 45, this will be kilonewton meter. I'll convert it in newton mm, so this will be multiplied by 10 raised to 6 newton mm. If I use this relation in this equation, 45 into 10 to the power of 6 must be equal to, you know the value of B, this is 1 by 6 into B is the width of the beam 200 mm and D is 400 mm square into F. So only unknown here is F. So bending stress F is given by solving this 8.44 newton per mm square. It is a rectangular section, so the neutral axis will be at the center. If you draw the bending stress diagram for this, if I take a line here, so maximum compressive stress here and maximum tensile stress here will be 0. If I join these three points, this is the maximum tensile stress, because tension is at the bottom. This is 8.44 newton per mm square, and this is the compressive stress, sigma c is equal to 8.44 newton per mm square. Both are same here, Fc and F, sigma c and sigma t, or I can call it as Fc and Ft. Stresses we call it either by F or sigma. So this is a very simple problem where you have drawn the bending stress diagram for a rectangular beam carrying UDL. Similar to other type of problem, suppose there is a simply supported beam, the span of the beam is 5 meters, it is carrying a UDL, let the magnitude of this UDL be 20 kilonewton per meter, This is a rectangular cross section. Width is B and depth is D. In this, you are required to find out the value of B and D. Given that D is equal to twice of width, depth is twice of the width. This is a condition given to you. Another condition given to you will be the permissible bending stress is given to you. Suppose if the permissible bending stress is 50 Newton per mm square, you are required to find out the dimensions. Whenever you come across dimension, the important factor will be I. If load is known to you, span is known to you, you can find out the bending moment. Bending stress is given to you. So we use relation M is equal to Fz. F is known, M will be known to you, Z will be in terms of B and D. You'll have to simplify B and D and find out the value of B and D. Suppose here, if M is equal to F into Z, Z is equal to I by Y. We know the moment of inertia of a rectangle is BD cube by 12. So this is equal to B is as it is, D if I take it as 2B cube divided by 12. So if you simplify this, 2 cube will be 8 by 12, 2 by 3 B cube. So it will be 2 by 3 B fourth. 2 by 3 B fourth. Now, Y is the distance of extreme fiber from neutral axis. So this will be equal to D by 2. So this will be equal to 2B by 2 because D is 2B. So this will be equal to B. So if I use the relation, M is equal to 1 by 6 F B D square. So this will be equal to, or I can use directly this value only because I know the values here. I'll calculate Z. Z is equal to I by Y. So we know value of I is 2 by 3 B raised to 4, and Y we know is the value as B. So this will be equal to 2 by 3 B cube. 2 by 3 B cube. Here if I substitute the value of bending moment, M what we get is WL squared by 8, simply supported carrying UDL. 20 into 5 squared divided by 8. So this bending moment will be equal to 62.5 kilo Newton meter. If I simplify all the values, so M is equal to Fz. If I use the relation, M is 62.5, this is in kilo Newton, multiplied by 10 raised to 6 to convert it in Newton, into F is the permissible bending stress, which is 50, into Z we have calculated the value as 2 by 3 into B cube. So if you simplify for B here from this equation, you get the value of B as 123.3 mm, and D is nothing but twice of width, so this will be equal to 246.6 mm. So this is another type of problem which you can expect, where bending stress is given and you are finding out the cross section of the beam. In this case also, the bending stress diagram will be uniform. Tension and compression both are same. We get the same diagram as we had drawn in the earlier problem. So coming to the next type, suppose there is an I section, unsymmetrical I section. Suppose the I section is like this. This width is 100 mm. This width is 200 mm. That means it is unsymmetrical along x-axis. Let this thickness be say 20 mm. Let this thickness be 20 mm. And this width be say let it be 100 mm. This is a I section. You are required to draw bending stress diagram. Bending stress diagram. And we know whenever you go for bending stress, M by I is equal to F by Y. M is given to you in this problem. Suppose the bending moment acting in this problem is say 50 kilonewton meter. Moment is given to you. You are required to find out the bending stress. M by I is equal to F by Y. You are required to draw the bending stress. You can find out this Y. Important thing in such problem is to find out the moment of inertia. So calculating moment of inertia is important in this. So to find out moment of inertia, first you are required to find out where is the centroid of this given figure. Y bar is equal to sigma ay by sigma a. That will give you y bar. Then you will have to find out the moment of inertia about the neutral axis of the I section. So we will go with the simple method to find out the centroid and moment of inertia. This is very important thing for you to find out the moment of inertia. Very simplest way I am showing you to find out the moment of inertia. Suppose now there are three components. If I call the components as G1, this centroid is center G2, this centroid is center G3. G1, G2 and G3 are the centroids of the elements. Now we are required to find out the distance of the centroid of the component from bottom. If I take it from bottom, 1, 1, if I take it as bottom, then we use the relation sigma ay by sigma a. So this is equal to, we will begin with component 1, 200 by 20 is the area and it is at the center. The distance of centroid from 1, 1 will be, total is 20, half of that will be 10 plus. We'll go for the second element. Suppose this thickness is also 20 mm. What will be the area? 20 into 200 into, we know the distance of the centroid of the rectangle is at the center. This total is 100, so this will be 50, but I want the distance from 1, 1. So this is 50 plus 20 mm, so this will be equal to 70 mm plus. I'll go to the third component. 100 by 20 is the area and the centroid is at the center. I want the distance from 1, 1, from here to here. This is 20, so this is at the center. 10 plus 100 plus 20, so this is the distance. What you get? 20 plus 100 plus 10, so this will be 130 mm. This is sigma ay, whole divided by area known to you, 200 by 20 plus 20 into 100 plus third area is 100 into 20. If you simplify this, you get the distance of y bar as 55 mm from bottom. So this is the first thing what you'll have to do. So here it will be slightly towards the lower portion. So this is the neutral axis, what we call neutral axis, NA, and the distance of the neutral axis from the bottom is 55 mm. So the distance from the top of the neutral axis will be, this is YT because in tension, this will be YC because it is in compression. So total depth is 20 plus 100 plus 20, 140 minus 55. So this distance will be equal to 85 mm. Once you find out these values, then the next job is to find out the moment of inertia. To find out moment of inertia, we need the distance of the centroid of the component from neutral axis. Means, I need the distance of the centroid of the component from neutral axis. I need the distance of the centroid of the component from neutral axis. I need the distance of the centroid from the neutral axis. Let us try to locate those distances here. Suppose the distance from G1 to neutral axis, this. See, this is 55. This is 10. Center. So 55 minus 10 will be equal to 45. So this is of importance for us. Similarly, distance of the centroid of the component from the neutral axis. I need this distance. Use the geometry of the figure and find it out. See, I can find out this distance because it is 20 plus 100 plus 20. 140 divided by 2. So this distance will be 140 divided by 2, 70. And this distance is 55. So 70 minus 55 will be equal to 15. 75 is equal to 15. This is of importance for us. Similarly, the distance of the centroid of the component from the neutral axis. I need this distance from here to neutral axis. This total is 85 minus this thickness is 10. So 85 minus 10 is 75. Once you find out these three values, it will become very simple for you to find out the moment of inertia. So here, the moment of inertia of the component and the moment of inertia of whole figure are not matching or coinciding. So we will be using the relation parallel axis theorem. Moment of inertia about any axis is given by moment of inertia about its own axis plus A into y bar square. We are going to use this principle to find out the moment of inertia. Suppose if I apply that principle here to find out the moment of inertia, so when you draw sketch, you draw more depth, more clear figure, so that you can plot all the things on that. So here, neutral axis, moment of inertia about neutral axis is given by, now we'll begin with G1. So IX axis, moment of inertia of the component about its own axis. So this will be rectangle is BD cube by 12 plus A is the area of the component and y bar is the distance of the centroid of the component from the neutral axis, which we already located. Things will go very simple once you draw this figure. So let us begin with 200 into 20 cube by 12. Plus A y bar square. A is 200 by 20 into y is 45. Don't forget to square this. It is a y square. So this is for G1 component. Similarly, we'll go for G2. It is also a rectangular section. Moment of inertia is b d cube by 12. So here is b is 20 and d is 100 cube divided by 12 plus a y bar square. A, what is the area? 20 by 100, this component. 20 by 100 into distance of the centroid of the component from the neutral axis. This distance is 15. So this will be equal to 15 square. So this is for G2. Plus, we'll go for G3. This is again rectangle BD cube by 12. So 100 into 20 cube by 12. Plus A y bar square, what is the area? 100 by 20 into distance of the centroid of the component from the neutral axis. What is this distance from here to here? This is 75. So this will be equal to 75 square. All the three components are over. If you simplify this, you get 200 point, or if I simplify all the values, you get finally moment of inertia about neutral axis is equal to 21.673 into 10 to the power of 6 raised to 4. This is the moment of inertia. Major concentration is on this only. If your I is correct, then only the other things will be correct. So y bar, then I. Then what is to be found out will be from the figure. Whatever may be the type of problem, you are required to find out I and y. So here in this problem, he has asked you to draw the bending stress diagram. He has given you the moment. We know M is equal to I by Y into F, or M by I is equal to F by Y. So here we know the value of I, we know the value of Y, we know the value of, we have to find out the permissible bending stress. So F is given by M into I by Y. Okay, so now here bending stresses will be different at top and bottom because the neutral axis is not at the center, it is different. So yt will be different, yc will be different. So using the values of yc and yt, we will find out the bending stresses. So bending stress at tension side will be equal to M by I into Y tension side. So this is Y tension side. So this will be equal to 50 is the moment. It should be converted in Newton per m, Newton mm, and I is 21.673 into 10 to the power of 6 into tension side is 55. So you get the value of bending stress in tension as 126.89 Newton per mm square. Similarly, bending stress on the compression side will be M by I into, instead of YC it will be YT, it will be YC. So this will be equal to M is 50 into 10 to the power of 6 divided by 21.673 into 10 to the power of 6 into YC. YC is 85 mm. So this should be multiplied by 85. So this will be equal to 196.1 Newton per mm square. 196.1 Newton per mm square. And if you draw the bending stress diagram for these values, if I extend these lines, top, bottom, center line, and this is a neutral axis. If you plot the bending stress here, this value of bending stress is 126.89 Newton per mm square. This is Ft. And here the bending stress value will be Fc, will be equal to 196.1 Newton per mm square. So this is tension and this is compression. At the neutral axis, the bending stresses will be zero. This we call it as the bending stress diagram. Like this, any figure given to you.